Subscribe to Marg Tutorial YouTube channel and press this bell icon so you can stay updated with latest videos. Hello friends and welcome to this tutorial in which we will see the ICICI online payment integration and bank reconciliation registration process with Marg ERP. For this, very firstly, we will come on online banking to registration field and then enter on ICICI bank field. So, a window of admin supervisor detail will be displayed where owner will fill all these fields for data security purpose or to save the data so that it doesn't get misused. And this step is mandatory to fill the details as if someone takes the backup of the data and then restores it somewhere else or copy Marg folder, then with the help of this option, the data will not get misused. Any kind of operations related to ICICI will not get executed. So in case if any unknown user or unauthorized person visits to ICICI registration, then the information will be sent to the admin or supervisor in form of an OTP. And admin or supervisor acknowledged that someone are trying to misuse their data. So in order to fill this window, we will click on edit and then click on save and register. Once the details are being filled, a window of information updated successfully, admin details on server will get displayed. Then we will click on OK. Now the ICICI registration window will get displayed as we are registering for the first time. So we will click on add button and there are different fields under ICICI registration window where the first field is select ICICI bank and all the bank accounts which exists in the organization will get displayed here. And from this drop down, select the bank account which needs to be registered, then click on OK. Then is ICICI bank account number. Enter the account number and if it exists in the ledger, then it will be picked by Marg software automatically. And we can click in show values in order to view the values that the account number which we are registering is right or wrong. And by default, software hide this. Then is ICICI corporate ID. Enter the corporate ID which is being provided through ICICI Bank. So here you will get two options, already linked and new ID. If you know that the bank which is being selected in ICICI Bank field is already linked with any corporate ID, then click on already linked. And from this drop down, select that corporate ID. Because I know that this account of mine is already linked with this corporate ID, which I have already registered once. Because I have to register only one time, whether I have three accounts means I have three ledgers and linked with one corporate ID. So I will register once only. Else create a new ID by clicking on new ID. And the benefit of this option is that if we have two ICICI accounts, that is, one account is linked with the corporate ID and another is sensitive, in which all the funds are being kept and I don't want to transfer the funds from Marg of this bank. So we do not link it. We will only link that account through which funds needs to be transferred. Then next is user ID. Here you will feed user ID. Then is allow server IDs. Enter that server IDs only for which the supervisor or the admin will give the authority for executing the ICICI related operations like fund transfer, bank statement, bank reconciliation, etc. When we add a new ICICI account, then a unique ID appears by default of the admin system server. And to find unique server IDs, go to Masters, Marg Licensing, Exception Code and Unique ID. And the same process is applicable for computer unique IDs as well. The benefit of allow server IDs and allow these computer IDs option is that an unauthorized person will not be permitted to execute any kind of operations related to ICICI through an unknown system. And to see these both IDs, you will go to Master, then Marg Licensing, then to Exception Code, Unique ID. So you can see here, means it is a server ID or computer ID of the user or supervisor who runs this PC. And every user will have different server ID and computer ID. The admin will have the authority to permit which user can execute the operations related to ICICI, and for that, the user will provide his/her unique ID to the admin. So you will feed that server and computer ID here, then click on save, and here the method of save is, suppose if we need to change the values in any of the fields or there is any mistake once all the fields are being filled, like I had a doubt that this server ID has a mistake. So we can save and keep it in local, and the value gets saved in the system and we can register it afterwards. Then after saving these fields, here you will see that terms and condition field is shown to you and it's mandatory to read. From here, you can read all the terms and conditions. Now we will need to register. For that, we will click on save and register, and as we will click on save and register, these details will get uploaded on ICICI portal. And we need to log in into ICICI portal and approve the registration process. Once the registration process is approved on ICICI portal by you, then it will be finally approved by ICICI within roughly 1 hour. And after completing the registration, in order to visit to ICICI portal, we will click on registration navigation process from here. Then a window of registration approval navigation will be displayed where the whole process is shown. Like to complete the registration, customer has to log in to ICICI Bank CIB portal. And then you will see the shortcuts like CIB login, pending on me, then connected banking approval, then mark, then approve, and then confirm. And here we can click on go to ICICI login page and can directly switch to the ICICI portal. So an ICICI login window will appear in front of you. Like from here, we will log in with the password and then we will click on proceed. Then click on pending on me. Then from here, click on connected banking approval. Then click on OK and then confirm it. Then click on done. Once all these details for the registration is approved on ICICI portal by you, then it will be finally approved by ICICI within roughly 1 hour. And to check the status, we will click on check registration. So an alert window of no information received from bank will appear. This means that the approval is still pending from the bank. And afterwards, when we recheck the registration status after roughly 1 hour, then a message of registration successful will be shown. Now our registration process will be completed. Now we will come to the main window. Once the registration process is completed, then we can further do the process like payment, schedule payments, payment history, bank reconciliation, online statement, etc. Marg has initiated the process of marker and checker in this module. That is, the admin or supervisor will permit for the process of fund transfer to the user. But that user will not be able to do the actual payment, as those payments will get scheduled and it can be only done by the checker. Now let's do online payment, for which we will click on payment field, select the ledger to whom the online payment needs to be done, enter the amount, and here that bank will appear through which we can do the payment. Press enter key. So an alert message of beneficiary bank account number is blank, wish to enter details will be shown. Because we have not mentioned an account, until you will mention an account number, software will not initiate the payment. So we will mention an account number, then mention IFSC code, and after this, your cursor will switch on to the payment mode, where software will ask you for the mode of payment, that through which mode you want to do the payment, like through IMPS, NEFT or RTGS. Or in own to own account, it means any of ICICI linked account, and ICICI to ICICI means payment to external ICICI account. Then we will read terms and conditions from here, in which whichever protocol, means whichever rules are being in net banking, the same rules will be shown to you and applied as well. And there is nothing like that Marg software has changed anything in it. After this, as you will click on initialize, an OTP will be there. After that, submit button will be shown to you. Enter on that. After the submission, payment has been submitted. In this, there is one more option. We will enter on payment option again. And here we will mention the date. and if this date is of future, so software will take it in scheduled payment. So this window of online fund transfer will be open, where you will see that scheduled payment field is showing you in red color, and it is indicating you that this payment have not made yet. It's been scheduled for future and software will not ask you for OTP pin in it. And from payment mode, you will select the mode of payment in which you want to do the payment. So software will save all these details in its record and it will be reflected to you in the module of scheduled payment. And that will be done through scheduled payments, in which from the drop down, first select the bank, an account number will be picked by software automatically. And in date, you will mention that date till you want to see the scheduled payment. So in this way, here party's name and amount will be there. Then click on OK and select from here that the payment which you want to initiate. As you can see on the screen, software is showing that like this account number and of this IFSC code, 12,000 payment of this date is being due. And if you will click on initiate payment from here, then for the first time, software will ask OTP from you. And then here, instead of initiate payment, an option of make payment will be there. Once we will do the make payment, then your payment will be done. Then is payment history. From this option, you can see pending and successful payment altogether. Means which are our payments are pending and which are successfully done. Means from our side, it is transferred and credited in beneficiary account. Then you can see from successful payments. And pending means payment is done from our side, but it is pending from party. Means payment has not been received to party hand. Next is bank reconciliation. And from this option, you can do bank reconciliation. Means software will ask you the bank name and in up to date, till which date you want to reconcile. Mention that date here and we will click on OK. Then this kind of screen will be open in front of you. This is my ICICI Marg's ledger and this is bank statement. You can see this is shown in red color, means this is non-reconciled because there is no clearing date in it. You can see we have deposited 5,000 on date 2nd, but when bank has cleared that payment, it is not shown. Similarly, you will see here we have deposited check on date 7 of this amount, which is shown pending in the status. If we will click on reconcile, so on the basis of this voucher narration and this description in statement, you will see the check number is here. In narration, there is 0 digit and in description, there is no 0 digit. So software is doing tally the amount of both on the basis of it. On the basis of it, software is telling the entries are reconciling simultaneously with each other. And those which are not reconciling are shown below, are in Marg's ledger and in statement. As you can see, here are few entries and you want that software will show its intelligence by auto-reconciling these entries. So, what software did, here the 4 entries are reconciling. As you can see in date and books as well, it's a date 2. And in statement as well, there is a date 2. Normally, there cannot be a date before that. Suppose we have given any check, so either it will get cleared today or after. And these are those entries which are not reconciled till yet, which are in our Marg ERP books. And here in details in bank statement, there are entries which are in statement but are not reconciled. Now, what we will do? Now, suppose here in Marg ERP books, there is a date 7, serial number 3 is shown and here in bank details statement, there are 2 entries of 2000. But you know that the serial number 3 belongs to the reference of this statement. So you will select it 3 from here and similarly, you know that serial number 6 belongs to this. So here we will select 6, then click on update. So a window of are you sure to save the changes in books will be displayed in front of you. Click on yes to save it. So in this way, software will show you an alert message that the number of entries are updated yet. As you will click on OK, you will see these entries in green color. Means these entries are updated and reconciled. And the entries are shown to you in red color are not updated till yet. Means these are not reconciled. So the entries which are in red color, let's update them and reconcile them. From this, we will click on pending. So in this way, software will show you pending entries. Now, software is asking you that against which ledger you want to put these pending entries. Now, suppose it's an entry of interest. Firstly, we have to do its entry in Marg. So, for this, from here, we will select ledger. We have selected bank and ledger. So, you will see bank charges will be there in entry against ledger. Then, click on add to books from here. So, into Marg books, our entry will be saved. Then we will do yes on wish to save changes and come to the main window. Then come to online statement option where you will select the bank and mention the date here from when to which date you want to see the statement. And this is only bank statement from the side of bank. There is no link with Marg book. Then from transaction field, you will select that you want to see all transactions or deposit transaction. If you will select all, then bank statement like this will be open in front of you. And if you want to see deposit transactions, then you will select deposit here. Then in filter on field, you will see few options are shown in drop down. From here, you can set filter that till what amount you want to see the deposit transaction. Like we want to see deposit of greater than 2000. So for that, we'll set deposit in transaction and greater than in filter on and in amount field. We will mention 2000. So in this way, software will show deposit transaction to you. Now we will come to the main window and then from apply for loans field, we will apply for loans as you will click on this option. Then this page will be open in front of you. This is basically to apply loan. You will fill the details. Then ICICI team will contact you on their own for loan. So friends, we have seen in this video that how we can do the ICICI online payment integration and bank reconciliation registration process in Marg ERP. Thanks for watching.